say. You look at whosoever the things he has caused you or is causing you and boldly say. You look at whosoever is threatening your life or threatening you and boldly say. You are the one to boldly say. God has done his own part. But the scripture says he has given us this right now to boldly say. And what are we supposed to say? You say, I will not fear what man do to it, to me. For the Lord is my helper. Can you say that to yourself? The Lord is my helper. And I will not fear what man will do to me. How boldly say? How boldly say? How boldly say? And that relates to any promise you see in God's word. Any promise you see in scripture, you are supposed to boldly declare it. You are supposed to boldly confess it. You are supposed to boldly personalize the word. Don't read scripture like you are reading it to somebody. Read it like it, as if it was addressed to you, with your name written on it. That's how you appropriate scriptures. Hallelujah. For instance, we're going to see a scripture this morning. Psalm 27, verse 1. Psalm 27, verse 1. Kayeva Soshkala. Oh, Reba Baseke Bosha Kayabosha. Psalm 27, verse 1. Are we there? Are we there? I want every one of us to read it together. Are we there?
Yes.
Okay, 1, 2, go.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall I fear? The Lord is my strong and my life. From whom shall I be afraid?
Ha ha. Verse 2.
When you bring a gift of my head, you my clothes. You have caused me to lift up my head. They stumble and fall.
That was like the song that was ministered by the choir this morning. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? You see, we live in a world where the devil and his agents are in constant plans. They're making constant plans, preparations. They're trying to attack the child of God. They're trying to do harm to the child of God at every count. They fashion and make weapons of every kind to attack the child of God, even against the church of God, constantly. That's why I tell people, somebody will wake up and say, oh, pastor, I had a dream. I just saw somebody chasing me with cutlass. Oh, I had a dream. I had a dream. I just saw one woman killing me. And I'm not telling you that you cannot have such dreams. God can speak to you and give you such revelations. Amen. But what I want to correct this morning is this. When you have such ministrations, dreams, or what, visions, you should not take it as a death sentence. That's what some people do when they make mistakes. When they have such dream, no matter what you tell them again, they already feel that it has happened, that it must happen. Say, pastor, any dream I had must always come to pass. That's the problem. Say, pastor, my dream does not fail. My dream does not fail. Hallelujah. And that's a big lie. Big lie from the pit of hell. We've been given power to make change. Even when something seems to be real, it's not real. We can make change by the power of the Holy Ghost. If it's not right. If it is right, we'll confirm it with an amen. And it, so shall it be. But when it's not right, why is it that God shows it to you? When God shows to you. Of course, the devil also shows some. Take note of that. When God, what's the difference between what God shows to you and what the devil shows to you? When the devil shows something to you, he wants you to receive it just as he has shown you and for you to die just before any other alternative, just that. Receive it and don't think any help can come. That's why scripture says in John 10:10, he said the devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus says, but I have come that you may what? Have life. And have it, not just only life, but have it in abundance. Which means to the full till it overflows. That's the life that Jesus has come to give us. So when you have such dreams, don't think it's the end. You rise on your feet. And you begin to speak God's word. He said, he's come to give me life, an abundant life. Therefore, death has no place in me. Sickness has no place in me. Begin to proclaim God's word over your life. That's how to attend to such issues. So the scripture will write, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? And that's very instructive. You know, sometimes we miss it. Sometimes we make some mistakes, some colossal mistakes as children of God. And the devil thinks he has got us on the edge. But you know what? God knows our heart. He weighs our every intentions. Even when we make the mistake, because God knows our heart. It's like David. God knew his heart. Even when he made some mistakes and errors, he did some nasty things. But God knew his heart. His heart was with God. His intention was ever to please God. And you know what? No matter what was done against him, God preserved him. God protected him. Because God knew his heart. Hallelujah. So we are children of God. If we have a heart for God, even when the enemy thinks we made a mistake, we made an error, and it comes against us, the Lord will rise against him by his spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He said, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? He said, where my enemies, even the wicked, they rose up against me to eat up my flesh. They stumbled and fell. You see, he related this to the scripture we read earlier. When he said, we shall say with our mouth, then you begin to proclaim the scripture. When you have such dreams, you have somebody threatening your life, you have such things happening around you, you begin to proclaim God's word. No matter who rises against me, no matter what devils rise against me, no matter what familiar spirit rises against me, they have just one end. They have just one end. They have just one end. What's the end? To what? Stumble and fall. Hallelujah. And that's how God expects you to proclaim his word over your situation, over the circumstance of your life. We're having our brethren who are celebrating birthdays today. It's the Lord who has kept them. It's the Lord who has preserved them. It's the Lord who has protected them. And that can be applied to every one of us here in the house. We must understand something, that the Lord never leaves us nor forsake us. He said, for he has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So I'm speaking to you this morning who think the situation is becoming too much for you. I'm speaking to you this morning who think that your life has come to such a point that there is nothing you can do anymore. I'm speaking to you this morning who think you have come to the end of your journey. Listen, the Lord is assuring you this morning that he is your helper. He is the one that will help you. Even when men have given up on you, when women have given up on you, when situations seem to have given up on you, if only you can trust God this morning, all things will be made beautiful in his time. I say all things will be made beautiful. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That same scripture continues in verse 27, verse 3. He said, though an host should do what? Encamp against me, and my heart shall not what? Fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will what? I be confident. Verse 4. One thing I desire of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. To do what? To behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. There's something about being in his temple. Amen. There's something about being in his temple. It brings beauty to our lives. It brings direction to our life. It gives meaning to our lives. Hallelujah. And there's somebody here this morning. All these three that I just said, you've not been experiencing it in your life. You've not been experiencing beauty. You've not been experiencing direction and you've not been experiencing meaning to your life. But today, thank God you are in His house this morning. From this day forward, the light of God will give you direction.
Amen.
The light of God will give you direction.
Amen.
The eyes of your understanding is being enlightened. You begin to get the beauty of God reflecting in you. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If you've been losing before, now from this moment forward, you begin to experience great victories.
Amen.
You know, there's something about the child of God who truly understands the God that he serves. The scripture we read earlier during the rhapsody reading in 2 Corinthians 2 verse 14, he said, now thanks be unto God who always, not sometimes, who always causes us to triumph. For the child of God who has faith in him, no matter the situation, even when you think you are tired, God makes you to triumph. Even when you think you are giving up, He gives you the extra energy to triumph.
Amen.
And from this day forward, I prophesy this over your life, over your situation, over your finances, over your health, over your business,
Amen.
Over your family, the Christ to triumph.
Amen.
Begin to manifest upon your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When the enemy thought they have brought you down, the ability to rise again is upon you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For He causes you to triumph. He causes you. Even when you don't think you have the energies, He causes you. When you think you are done for, He causes you. When you think you are dead, He causes you. When He thinks you run out of ideas, all of a sudden, the Lord gives you the supernatural strength and ability to rise up and triumph and win in the circumstance and win in the situation and win concerning the health situation and win concerning the family. From this day forward, you begin to win.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
Amen.
You triumph over darkness. You triumph over forces of hell. You triumph over witches and wizards. You triumph over the oppression of Satan. You triumph in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For the child of God, nothing is impossible. Why? Because God is my helper. Let's rise on our feet. Begin to proclaim and say, Lord, you are my helper. Thank you. Thank you. I will not fear what man do to me, because the Lord is my helper. The Lord is my helper. My Baba Seke Go Shaka. Taye Baba Rekete. Roseke Barakataya. Re Baba Teko Shakaya. Begin to proclaim. Confess boldly the word of God over your life. He said, so that I may boldly say, so that I may boldly declare, the Lord is my helper. I can't fail. I can't be down. I can't be defeated. I can't be disappointed. For the greater one in me, the Lord is my helper. For even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. For the Lord is my helper. For the greater one in me, my life is mine. Head is mine. Strength is mine. Increase is mine. Favor is mine. My prasete go shakaya. 1,000 before by my side. 10,000 by my right hand. When the ears are hear the destruction of the wicked, it shall not come nigh me. It shall not come nigh those people. It shall not come nigh the church. My barata church kelemos. Rabarakate. For he causes me. He causes me to triumph. He maketh me triumph. Mandabarosha. Over situations, over darkness, over the forces of them, he causes me to triumph. Barreca, check the bush. Back at the rush, Skyaka.